This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA, and by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com. To Spindling and our tutorial unlocked. For this tutorial, you need some wool locks. Yep.
And some, I put mine with some roving.
Yeah. So you can do like locks and top, locks and a back, or locks and locks. It's kind of the same thing we just did with uncarded, but we're going to be focusing on locks. In this tutorial, Sarah's going to be blending her locks with her top, and I'm going to be spinning locks together, and then I'm also going to get into tail spinning. So this is also a tail spinning technique tutorial brought to you by letter T.
There you go.
So let's see. I'm just going to put my fiber here. I've got some mohair. I've got some BFL. I've got some Wensleydale. That's mohair.
Okay.
And then your top is from Busy Bee Fibers on Etsy.
It's a gorgeous.
Yeah. It's like when she sent that to me, I was like, oh. Like I loved it. Loved it. Easiest way for me to attach yarns is to fluff up the end and then just kind of fluff up the beginning of the next part and pinch them together. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do, this is a short staple length. I'll come to that in a bit.
I think I'm going to start pinching the roving first and then add in these locks.
That's a good idea.
You'll grab it better.
I'm struggling to get started, so I'm going to make a cloud. Because I'm like, I don't know, like.
Let's try that.
They need to come up with how to spin caffeine into yarn. Yeah, I like this. Okay. That's really pretty.
That is.
I really like that. Okay, so we'll take a bit of that. Yay! Beautiful.
Oh, that spins up nice.
I love. I would spin that every day. Like, it's one of my favorite fibers in my stash. And when I found it for this, I'm like, oh, we have to use some of that. Ooh, I really, really, really like this. I really, 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 really like this. This is like
it
one of my
like
favorite.
An art pad.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite textures is locks.
I'm finding that it's easier for me if I switch off which one is the main thread.
Yeah.
So like now it's locks, so let me add this in, and then it will be the top, and then I'll add the locks in.
So like rotating back and forth.
Right. Mm-hmm. I think it's just easy for me to concentrate on one instead of two.
Yeah. And that's probably across the board, like when you're starting, because a lot of these techniques I've done only on a wheel. I've never done on a spindle before. So I'm coming from this where I know how to do the technique, but I'm using a different tool. And Sarah's coming from this where she knows how to use the tool, but she's never done this technique. So it's like, we're all learning together. So if you're coming from a wheel or you're coming from a spindle, we're all in the same boat. That's really pretty. I'm going to show that to you. I like this a lot. It's very flowery.
Fancy.
I like it.
I feel Like, I need more weight for the locks.
Mm-hmm. They do require a lot of, I find that this spindle is working well for me, okay. but I'm also doing bulky.
Okay. Yeah, maybe locks is just a little more bulky than I'm used to on this spindle.
Yeah, I think they're bulky as locks. Like locks, yeah. Like I don't know. I think if you were to try to spin them really thin, it would end up getting rid of some of the texture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you almost have to fluff the lock out of it.
Mm-hmm. Look at this. I love that. And you can see there's not too much twist in it. If you find that you've drop spindled a yarn like this and then you take it off and it doesn't feel secure, like it doesn't have enough twist in it, you can always ply it. And if you buy the entire series of spindling, you get 10 single spinning videos and 10 plying videos. So you can ply this yarn using any of the 10 plying techniques that are in the masterclass. Mix and match. I really like this. Like, I'm loving this. Like, this is really pretty.
Locks are the only things that can give you these particular.
It celebrates the sheep.
Yes. Even when it's thin, it's just
Look at you have like a halo. Mm-hmm. Yes. That's really pretty. Cool.
That's pretty neat.
Okay, so now I'm going to get into tail spinning. And tail spinning is where you spin locks so that they hang out as long as possible. It's a very popular art yarn technique. I don't know if I'll be able to do it, but let's try. Let's try. Tail spinning does require a little bit of prep work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate these. I think they're Wensleydale locks and line them up. And if you find this tail spinning technique too complicated, I do have another technique in the plied series of this masterclass, plying locks, that creates a very similar look as this yarn that's more secure and easier to start with. So if you really want to add locks into your yarn, you can always ply them in as well. Okay, so I've got a pile of locks here that are all separated. And I think what I'm going to do I want you to see when I'm adding them. So I'm going to fluff up some of these mohair locks so that you can see the white Wensleydale contrasting with the mohair. So I need kind of a fuzzy base fiber to make it all grab together. And I'll hold that in my hand. And we'll get started. With that. And now I'll take the end of one of these Wensleydale locks. You can see the locks kind of come to a point. So I want the fluffy end, and I'm going to pinch the fluffy end with the fluffy part of what I'm spinning. And just kind of spin them together.
That's gorgeous.
So you can get locks like hanging out.
That's pretty securely on there too.
Yeah, I mean, if I really wanted to rip it off, I could. Spindled yarns, I find I can't get as secure as wheel spun yarns, but again, if you wanted to spin locks back to back, you could always ply them with thread, and that really secures them. Also, mohair might be really slippery. Might not be the most secure fiber to get these
locked into.
What do you do when you find that your drop spindle starts twisting backwards really quickly? Do you add more weight?
Yeah, usually add more weight.
Because, like, I feel like I'm twisting it, and then it's bouncing back, like, really fast.
I think that's just the momentum of the twist being stronger than the momentum of the spindle. So the weight helps it, I find. Also, I make a really secure, like, anchor, so I wrap it around a couple times, especially with locks, because I find otherwise it tends to do that as well.
That's a lot easier. Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes it's one of those things where you don't know how much you need the weights until you add them, and you're like, oh.
Yeah, and it's like a whole new spindle.
Yeah. It's like driving on the wrong gear or something.
Yes. So there's... so yeah, you can go back to back to back to back with those. I don't think that that's my favorite look, but let me try more, because I know people at home want to see back to back to back. So now I think instead of adding them into the slippery mohair, I'm going to try to spin these back to back, end to end, because this is a lot of people's favorite style of art yarn. I think this is going to be a sideways method.
Probably.
Yeah. This is a detailed. Okay, so I've wrapped my lock around the outside of my mohair, and now I'm going to get another lock and twist that around. I'll get another lock, fluff up the end, pinch it with the very tip of your yarn, and twist that around. See how I'm keeping the end fluffy? So always keep the end nice and fluffy. It creates a really secure place to add in your next lock. Yeah, this is tails fun.
I love it. That must be so nice to knit up.
It's super bulky.
I love it.
How's yours coming out?
Pretty good.
I like those colors together a lot.
It's interesting. It's like, it's the traditional style, but it looks artsy.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Pretty cool.
I'm not enjoying this tail spinning technique, frankly. So I'm going to cheat at it. I'm going to just take a handful of Wensleydale locks and fluff them up and spin just from the handful, because I think that's going to create a similar technique. And then when the yarn is spun, you can pull out the ends. And I honestly think, like, you can see how the locks are hanging out of this one. And then as we go into the other technique, it's just more like bumpy. So I'm going to recommend that if you want to do a tail spun style yarn on your drop spindle with less grief, ply it. Just ply it. It's more secure, and I think that's why. It's more secure. And having a secure yarn that doesn't fall apart is, like, one of my biggest things. But yeah, I think I'm done. Let me show you my finished unlocked. And I'm keeping it kind of like an ice cream cone. It's pretty, you can see the top. Yeah.
And here's mine.
That's really pretty.
That's interesting. I like it.
Nice.
Cool.
Well, I hope you had fun spinning the locks in your stash. Cheers.
Cheers.
This falls apart. Happy spindling. Visit thisyarn.com for free patterns and projects exclusively designed for art yarns by art yarn spinners. What will you make with this yarn? If you have benefited from the education you received from my site and videos, pay it forward by making a donation on my website. Every donation goes toward my children's education. Thank you.